If it does occur and gets voted in, then we will amend the budget to get right to the end of wherever we need to be.
Okay.
Okay? What happens with the millage? We're gonna assess a couple hundred thousand dollars of the millage. And we're not gonna have it all collected by the time the town would dissolve. However, part of that revenue stream would help to pay off this, the existing debts that we don't have paid down at that point in time. Who's gonna collect that and administer it? I'm assuming the county will.
County, and the county would get the any extra revenues based on the millage.
Right.
So essentially, it's a debt because the taxes are collected in arrears. So as long, if we begin 2018, those amounts are due. So no matter what, the ad valorem taxes are due.
Right.
So that's gotta be paid. So whatever's left over goes to the comptroller's office and they set up new accounts and county will pay out of it.
Okay. But essentially, you know, when it gets passed, we've gotta sit down and do the rest of it. But it's gonna be a significant hit, but also, you know, there's gonna be a lot of things we're not gonna be picking up.
Sure, yeah, the liabilities will be passed on, but I just wanted to.
Well, some are, but the plan's gonna have, if memory serves me correctly from reading this, we need to pay them down as much as we can. And that's part of the dissolution thing.
The plan, we'll have a very detailed plan once we get the disposition of the vote. At this point, I mean, I hate to say we'll put cart in front of the horse, but we really are, but we need to be prepared for everything.
But due to the ordinance reading the way it does, I just wanna make sure that this is a doable thing if and when the time comes.
It should be. But you know, I'm gonna make that final determination in November.
Okay.
And we'll figure out how to make it work.
For clarification for myself, that it states that an amount equal to the amount the employee would be entitled to if the employee voluntarily resigned his or her employment within the town, and this is speaking of leave. You're saying that's 240 hours up to a max of 240 hours.
Yes, sir.
Based on our employee policy.
And then.
What if we stay with the town?
And that's one-third of the.
Sick time.
Sick time.
A question about the health insurance. It says that the town will pay 100%. Is that for the employee? What if it's got like family coverage? Will we pay 100% for the family coverage too?
You know, they say me, if I had that coverage, mm-hmm. I would be responsible for that part.
Right.
We will be paying.
So well, the 100% is for
why don't we walk. I'll tell you the rationale behind each one.
Okay.
All right, so employee salary, it's set up to where they would get a severance pay of 2 weeks, but only if they don't accept the job with the county.
That answers your question.
Yeah. So, no, that doesn't answer all of them. That answers salary only. You would get a severance. If you did not take the job, you'd get 2 weeks of pay. If you took the job, you don't get it. Also, we may run into situations where people, knowing that they're in the twilight of the town of Hastings potentially, that they go find another job. Obviously, they would not be entitled to severance. So,
So are they guaranteed, the county's guaranteed the workers a job already, or is that gonna be part of a document written?
There's gonna be an interlocal and probably an interlocal with the county. There is no guarantee. They've proffered that there's a guarantee, but from the town's perspective, we can't guarantee anything because they would have to guarantee that.
Mm-hmm.
And they offered that up in their meeting in St. John's County. The 20th, they had mentioned that they were going to offer the jobs to the town employees to stay where they are.
That they would hold open positions for the town employees, but it would still be at the town employees' discretion whether or not they accept that job.
Sure.
So there is no guarantee for the job.
That's correct.
Yes.
If we do take a job with the county, now, if
we got over 240 hours. Do we?
He's getting a good working out.
So, paycheck only. That's that treatment. Moving on to leave and vacation time or whatever that is. You would get, you would be entitled to the voluntary resign amount regardless if you went to the, regardless of whether you went to the county or elsewhere, right? Because when the county, when you go to the county, they aren't gonna accept all that leave and add it to your bank. So these people earned it and they should be paid for. And since we're no longer a corporation, we should honor that commitment. So you would be paid for that leave.
So you're starting.
You would be starting.
You're starting.
Okay.
Yes.
But you get paid.
Yeah.
For the retirement, the employee would still be entitled to, in the event that they went to the county, they would still get their Florida retirement system items.
Oh, you go ahead, Bert.
I was just, so that transfers.
Yeah, whether you're a state employee doing forestry or
the county, because they're in that too, right?
Right.
Okay.
And there should not be a break in service, correct?
I don't know how that works.
I wouldn't think so.
I wouldn't think so either, because the way the dissolution is prepared is that the last day would be February 28th, and then your first day would be March 1st, which I think is a Wednesday, and then Thursday. And then there's a good rationale behind the health insurance.
So can we find out if there will be a break in there for these families?
Well, it's something that the retirement system would have to tell us, because
right.
You're still a retirement system. You haven't gone, you've just changed from one Florida retirement system employer to another one.
Shouldn't be a break.
From them, it shouldn't be a break. Right. Now, if you went and had no job for 3 weeks and then picked one up, then that would be clearly some more of a grayish area, because then you've got a break in service with a state participating entity.
Well, yeah, there's a certain amount of money that's kicked over to that system.
We also have no authority over any of that.
Absolutely. Yeah. There is zero control over that.
Yeah.
There's nothing we can do.
Viewpoint wise.
Yeah. Health insurance, the way the health insurance is set up is that we currently pay 100% of the employees' health insurance. The reason why we have it set up at 100% continuing is because we need to pay it in advance. And the reasoning behind that is that once the corporation ceases to exist, the corporation can no longer have health insurance. So that's gonna have to be paid on February 28th, 2 months in advance for all the employees that are still here. The reason why we pay for 2 months is that in the event that Sam leaves the town and goes straight to the county on March 1st, he would have a 60-day waiting period to pick up health insurance. That would cover that 60-day waiting period before the county health insurance picked up.
I didn't think that's what the county said. Didn't they say they were going to be able to waive that?
Not the health insurance?
No, that's
health insurance.
Okay, I'm sorry, but that's what I thought it said.
The question I have is, when the dissolution of our town charter occurs on February 28th, are we allowed to pay in advance at the normal rate, or is the insurance company going to call it COBRA?
Well, that's the issue. You can't have a COBRA for an entity that doesn't exist. So we went round and round with the insurance carrier. This is how we have to do it.
And the insurance carrier said that this is...
This is, she has given
so
us.
So we pay 2 months in advance, they carry the insurance assets.
Okay. And COBRA is really a function of a full, when you get your COBRA letter and you say you pay $80 every 2 weeks, and you get your COBRA letter, all it is, COBRA is just a fully loaded insurance premium. Right. So the amount of the premium doesn't change, but who pays it does.
Yeah.
So, The concept is that that most employees, maybe, I don't know, I haven't taken a poll, but conceptually this is drafted for the employees going to the county. Now, some people won't stick around. If they resigned in advance, you know, one issue is if you didn't pay, the leave and they did a resignation a week in advance, they would still get the 240 hours. I mean, so we don't want anyone gaming the system. We still need our yards mowed. We still, not yards, but our areas mowed and things of that nature. So the concept is that it just, it makes it a smooth transition for the employees that are going to go over to the county. For the people that wish not to go to the county, then this is essentially what they would get anyways. They'd probably get a windfall with the 2 week, they'd get a compensation of 2 weeks, and they'd get a windfall of the health insurance for two months. But they would still get the same amount of leave. So it's really set up for that.
I'm good with this so far.
That's it. Oh, and I do have in there, you will not be receiving pay.
Yeah, I heard that. I'm not going to protest that. If that happens, just let me know.
Not that you will.
I'll try to again. No, if I'm even here.
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
I have a question, kind of until the point of question, a dumb question. The dumb question you're the one that's going to ask. So my question is, is any way possible that the county could allow the workers to remain here as the workers and maybe just change whatever needs to change that will fit the county? Is that possible?
I ultimately, here's what I, how I envision this process happening. If and only if it is determined that we're going to dissolve. I envision that the county will keep everything exactly the same. On Wednesday, you came here as an employee of the town of Hastings, and on Thursday, you came here as the town, as the county employee. I do not think they're going to consolidate a single thing. I think they'll keep everything the same. They'll start working through the systems and figuring out how they can potentially get things more efficient. But if I were the county, I would, this is just me, I'd leave everything exactly the same for a year.
I agree.
And then figure out what you're going to do throughout that year to figure out how you're going to, you know, who you need to bring in here, what staff is great here that they could potentially use in the county and things of that nature. But there's no way to dictate how it's going to happen. I would be willing to guarantee if you're here on Wednesday, you'll be here on Thursday because there's where else are you going to report to?
Right.
But how long that happens, I don't know.
Yeah, from a common sense perspective, why train new staff
to do
things that are being done here?
And nobody else knows what's being done here other than our staff.
Right. So I think Mike's right, but there's no guarantee again because the county could decide, okay, all of you guys go to Ponte Vedra and we're gonna bring in new folks.
Sure.
But I don't see that happening. It just doesn't make any sense.
It wouldn't make any sense.
Well, and I think what we need to understand too is, you know, in talking to the attorney that did the dissolution for the town of Cedar Grove, who is actually, he's in Tallahassee now. He was actually the county attorney with Bay County when Cedar Grove dissolved into Bay County, so he's very well versed in this. He's the only municipality that ever had dissolved. And I talked to him and he gave me his ear. And he said it took 2 years to do the final dissolution of everything. So I don't know if you saw the powers in here associated with the mayor and the vice mayor in the mayor's absence to sign documents, transferring things. It's going to take some time.
I'm sure.
You know, just from the staff and the accounting and the AR and the AP and the utilities, I mean, we have a fully operational business and, you know, there's a lot to do. And so they'll have to figure all that out. You know, that's not going to be our thing.
Yep.
They know their business and they know how they're going to make our business their business.
It's a doable thing.
Yeah, it is. I mean, yeah.
Or they can come figure it out themselves.
They will probably do a little bit of both. I think, oh, go ahead.
You want to finish that statement first?
No, go ahead.
I'm changing the subject.
Oh, I'm going to change it too.
Oh, you go? Okay.
No,
so right here at the second line, where it says,
right in the beginning?
At the beginning, first page. Page one. And I don't know whether you can amend this or not, where it says to complete a vote by the town's qualified electors to dissolve the. Now, does that mean this whole body agreed to doing this?
Vote.
Or? Because I voted against.
Just the vote.
Okay. because I voted against it. That's what I'm.